recently, Lin Gaoyuan twice. So we will see. Jung Young Shik to start. Now, one thing I will say that is this, assuming, you know, the German team put him into play, Timo, so it's assumed that he's in a condition where he couldn't just suddenly be completely out, because that would cost them two matches. I was going to say, he seems like he could play, you know, the smarter players and the more experienced players, I think, can play better injured than others. Sharath Kamalachantha in 2015, Sujo beat Simongo Z on injury. Granted, he was ahead when he was injured, but tactically, he could barely move. I think that experience paid off. Nice through the legs catch there from Timo Boll with the racket.
I wonder how many people spotted that. It was very, very clever, nice little pickup, wasn't it?
I'm surprised I spotted it. I was looking back at the door to our room for a moment. Wow, that makes me feel good. Well, this is Timo unfit. I mean, he looks to be in great shape. He's looping fast from both sides. Now, just one more credit that I think was quite a notable one. Jung Young Shik last night beat Harimoto, Tomokazu Harimoto, 11-9 in game five to set Korea off on the right foot. Left. One, three. Timo's a very clever player. He just has such clear ideas before he starts the point of what he wants to do, and he's capable of everything. One thing that's made him the most feared player of the modern generation in China is that his timing is so early off the bounce, he's so compact in his game. That being said, he's got a backhand that hooks, his spin variation is incredible, his services. And here I felt like the receive just left a little bit to be desired. Jung Young Shik getting the good opening. And again, Jung Young Shik earning that third ball. So the German fans making themselves heard in the crowd. Now, this is a little bit more of a fair battle, you would imagine. Well, fair isn't the right term. Everyone's welcome to be here. But when China was playing, it was clear there were thousands of fans in the crowd. Right now, I'd say Germany's fans versus Korea's fans might be a pretty close number. He looks a little bit rushed to me on that backhand. I don't know if that's a product of the human body or him trying to compensate for a weakness. In the replay, it actually didn't look quite so different. Usually, we see a very spinny shot from him. Perfect placement, parallel forehand. Timo ties it right back up. Don, I'm really curious how things are going to continue. What are you thinking, Don?
I'm sitting here with my fingers crossed, just hoping that everybody gets through the match.
Right.
Assuming they do, then this is going to be a close game. Both players fit. Jung Young Shik last night, you mentioned the Harimoto game. That was the first game on. He won that, and then he won the last game on against Mizutani. So he's in fine form. He's the Korean player. And I think Boll is such a wise man, a wise player, that he will, if he, he'll play within his injury as well.
Exactly.
He carries it well.
Right.
He knows what he can and he can't do. And he won't overstretch or go for, try and do things that he knows his body can't do. So I think he's, you know, that he's 37 years of age. He's a wise player.
And he actually became the oldest ever world number one. I think he joked that he was the slowest ever world number one, but just very humble. 4 years older than Janove Waldner, nearly five when Waldner became world number one at 32, previous record holder. Ooh, bottle challenge style serve. This one just hugs the line. With spin, again, this is the type that looks like it could have gone around the net post in theory. That's something I've yet to see. But it. Oh, that placement. Jung Yong-sik has the wide wingspan there, and he's quick to get to this ball. I think a lot of players would have had trouble even contacting this receive. Timo just guides it to the very corner. Good opening loop, strong enough from Jung Yong-sik.
I think he actually played that shot as his momentum was still going backwards, but he still managed to generate quite a bit of speed and spin.
Auf geht's, Timo. Come on, Timo, says the crowd. Wouldn't be surprised to hear some fighting for Jung Yong-sik. Just a reminder, the winner here will earn a spot to play against China in the final. Whoever it is, I hope they make it close. I feel like there's potential on both sides, but as you mentioned, the big question marks are Dima and Timo. Franziska started well, but Lee Sang-soo. It's a tough test, right? I mean, you're looking at world number 8 versus world number 24 for the first match. Lee Sang-soo expected to take at least one of his wins. Maybe both in this overall team match. A beautiful angle right off the bounce. That's Timo's timing gone.
And that's where it's so good, and you mentioned why the Chinese a worried by ball. Look, just look how early he takes the winner there. He's taken two or three quite early, and then whoosh. In he comes with that forehand topspin on the diagonal.
It's funny, in terms of fitness, Timo Boll working really hard to keep his fitness up, is doing push-ups right before he starts playing here, so he has some tension through the chest. It's a fine balance. If you work out too hard and you're too tight, you find yourself slow, but Timo said in his Ask a Pro Anything interview that he finds that it's nice to have a little bit of tension, not to mention this obviously keeps him sharp and fit to avoid fatigue in the long run. Timo Boll in a class of his own in terms of world ranking and age. It's funny, we've seen some, you know, Robert Gardoš, 39 years old, coming quite close to Ma Long, taking him to a fifth. Right now, Timo Boll with 2 game points on his serves. Got it! One is not enough. Jung Yong-sik saving game point on the receive. Take a look at this here. Pendulum serve comes just a little bit long. Not a very aggressive attack, but still had a little bit more backswing than if it was over the table more. Haven't seen as much of the reverse pendulum as I expected. China! 2 game points saved. If Korea goes up 2-0 in matches, this gets really tricky, Don. And that right there was the reverse pendulum serve. I wonder if it has something to do with his injury or what muscles are required in terms of his backhand counter. I remember a lot more points being won with his forehand in this game so far, Don. I think I've seen Jung Yong-sik serve 3 lets in a row in many tight games. He's just so calculated. His serves are very low to the net. More so than others, I would say. Obviously, all pros are quite well practiced on that. Oh, and he finishes it with the backhand. Again, I'll say it again, but Timo Boll varies the spin so well, and he can generate a lot of spin. He's comfortable in different paces of play, from that fast Chinese pace to, say, alternating it and spinning it a little bit more, slowing it down, and using different depths on the table as well. So serve back to Boll with the game point. And he gets it, the kick serve pendulum to the backhand side. 12-10, Timo Boll takes game number one, and we'll be back for game number two right after this. Good quick forehand off the bounce to follow up the reverse pendulum serve. You know, having faced Timo Boll's serves before, that reverse pendulum is very difficult to read. He just has complete freedom on what spin he can put on it with the reverse side spin. From top for a kick to heavy underspin, his wrist is very strong. Ooh, edge of the table. It's one way to get an ace.
The thought was good, the tactics were good. The execution was very fortunate. All 4 points going with service this second game.
Little shout out to Kim Dong-hyun, Lim Jong-hoon on the bench for the Korean team. Again, a bright future for those two as well. Short side of the table here, Boll taking a risk, leaving open the opposite side. But I think the surprise factor paid off. Doesn't miss by a lot. If that ball makes good contact on Jung Young Schick's racket, it's going the other way cross court. Oh, the hand switch. We've seen it so many times. Timo just runs way out wide. Says, if I need to, I have no chance to get back for a backhand here. How many times have we seen him win points with the racket in his right hand? Against Ma Long, I think, well, at least once. There's another time he ended holding it in his right hand and just turned around as if to say, wow, lucky me. This one's sitting up a little bit. Jung Young Schick in near the body, wrapping up, pulling up on this ball. Takes it just above net height. Good drive, good speed. Ooh. If Jung Young Schick blocks this one into play, that'd be incredible. Timo's moving quite well right now. He's really getting around the court.
That's exactly what I just thought. I was thinking he hadn't played many forehands from the backhand side. He's played a couple of beauties. And in fact, here, look, we'll have a quick look at his footwork and you'll see how well they're working. Here we go. Timo's footwork looks pretty impressive to me.
Oh, service error. You know, without that camera really does give you a good sense of how they're never really coming to rest. The players, even if they're moving or pivoting just a little bit, they're constantly like hopping and keeping their balance for every shot. It's a bit deceiving when you watch the players from here because you see their whole bodies and you think, oh, well, I have a general sense for where they are. But when you're looking at their legs and their feet, the reaction time and the lack of time that they have to move, it's just crazy.
Defense!
Perfect placement down the middle here. I was going to say, the fact that we're in Europe, it's a little bit more easy for people to come from Europe to be at this tournament. It's one reason Timo will have a little bit more crowd support. But quite frankly, I mean, Timo's got a good 20 years of being a world-class athlete on the world stage as one of the most popular players known to the game. So a whole lot of different factors here.
11, 5, 6.
So tying it up here, second towel break, Jun Young Schick with these tight serves and a variety of spins. You know, you called him a finesse player, not all the explosive power that Lee Sang-soo has, but he is varying his spins quite well, and he's playing the placement, as you mentioned, quite a smart player. Seems to be keeping this very close. This last one seems to get away from Timo a bit. Not sure if it was a break of rhythm here, but the contact wasn't quite that of his before. He broke the pattern playing two out to the forehand side. Is he opening backhand in the follow-up? From that angle, his forehand technique actually looked better on the second one than the first. A little bit less of an improvised shot, more of a typical Timo stroke. Persistent into the body on the backhand side. Jun Young Schick now, but three in a row, leading by two. The longer this match goes, considering Timo took the first, the tougher it'll be just simply being an injured player. That was the footwork of Jun Young Schick. Excellent point. I thought Timo played it well to block until he had the opportunity to go for power, but at that distance, Jun Young Schick is comfortable to counter back.
And he read the direction well. There's a good topspin down the line by Timo. Let's just have a quick look. He goes in this, there he goes. He's a little bit further away from the table than I thought when I saw the replay, but nevertheless, still, to spot the direction, return it on the angle was excellent.
Oh, incredible touch from under the table. Sounded like Jun Young Schick returned it off the hand on the second one. Let's see, one more time. Takes his time here. Keeps it very low to the net. Racket head straight up to block from in front of the body. Huh. Thanks for the look. I still couldn't tell. It was quite close. It was low on the racket, if anything. Bottle challenge serve deep to the backhand, a righty against a lefty or a lefty against a righty. And we've got a timeout now on the side of Jun Young Schick for the Korean team. Coach Don, what it is?
Coach Don, I think it's a good timeout. Woman that was there, 91 Sheba, Pearson beat Voldner in the final, and then 93 back to Gothenburg. And Sweden won in Gothenburg. And then 95 Tianjin and China won in Tianjin.
So let's see here, back from the timeout. Jun Young Schick on the receive, down, no, up by one. Oh, that angle. And this is the whole thing about hitting to the middle. You're trying to get someone slightly off balance to create an opening. It's a shot that sets up the wide winner. Timo gets exactly that here, just that hesitation. The Jun Young Schick is sort of rocking back to a balanced position, costs him the time for that wide angle. So Timo Boll has tied it up. Looking for a 2-0 lead on the receive here. That's an excellent read. This reminds me of Lee Song-soo over the back of the table, just so aggressive and hungry for that first attack. Just a little bit of side spin to carry that off the table. I felt like that one would have stayed on for a second bounce if it didn't have the bend and the kick on that second shot. Game point to Jung Young Shik, second serve here. Ooh, Timo hangs on, keeps the game alive. Again, Timo really looking to bring this home to Germany, as always, but especially now because he's depended on. He's playing two singles, looking to take 2 points, one here, one against Lee Sang-soo in the fourth singles match. If he wins this, there will be a fourth singles match, assuming everyone's healthy, no matter what. Timeout for Timo. Wow. You could hear the crowd shocked. He was about to serve. Not like it. Now's not a good time. Save it for later. Well, game point to Jung Young Shik once again. Oh, the net ball on the last one. Timo grunting for every shot, but a big win. It's Team China. And the invitation was extended. It's funny, it feels in some ways like long ago, but don't think it was actually that long ago that we saw Timo playing Chinese Super League. I remember him in some of the newer shirts, some of the more recent designs. So it couldn't have been that long. This is a more rhythmic rally here, very fast-paced. Timo's had, say, a bit longer rallies at this pace from time to time, but staying in near the table, we often see him create more angles. That's the deception on the reverse pendulum serve. The amount of underspin he generates. Get ready to dump it into the bottom of the net. Loaded with spin here for the forehand. A good start for Timo up 3-1.
Clever shot from Timo here. Ball was level with the table height, and he just brushed up the back of the ball, went for spin. Clever variation, won him the point.
The point throughout, this is the most counter loops and the fastest. That's human beings right there, that's what that is. Tough to imagine sometimes the way they move around and twist. I was just thinking, you know, there was a new Timo video released with him dreaming. I think he had a bad dream. And it showed him doing squats and other things. And then earlier we saw his quads and I was thinking, he has to work really, really hard to be so physically fit out here. He said in his interview who would win between 2005 Timo and 2017 Timo. And he thought about it for a while. He said, well, you know, he's a 2017 Timo. Yeah, he's more clever, more smart. But 2005 Timo, yeah, he's faster, stronger. I think he would win. I mean, he's beaten everybody in the world for the most part at some point or another. Ma Long in 2017. Ma Long years before. So very strong start here. Only 1 point dropped in the first seven. Timo with his second serve.
I think Jung Young Shik won the first point.
So you're telling me that Timo has scored seven in a row. I'm picking up what you're putting down, Don.
I'm telling you that's what I think.
Okay. Statement of fact. No, I got it. Serve back with Jung Young Shik. And Bull on a roll continuing here. Some big smiles from the Korean VIPs in the crowd. I think there were maybe wry smiles right behind the German bench. Maybe it's the G's. This guy's good. What are you going to do? You know, Don, you mentioned you saw the German team in the practice hall before and that they seemed like they were in good spirits.
They did. Yeah, they were training well, and there was a few smiles and a few laughs at the appropriate time. Well, they looked in good spirit.
Well, now 10-1. It's 9 game points for Timo Boll to take a 2-1 lead in games. Solid ripping backhand, a lot of power, and when he's in that close to the net, he's got less predictability from his opponent. Can pick the angles. Yeah, leaves Timo up on 1 foot there, reaching. Although we've seen that returned by Timo. From diving shots with his face near the ground, Timo never really seems to be out of the point. Oh, nice angle here. And the timing is crucial. He takes that really early off the bounce, just guides it out wide to the forehand side. Still a long way to go. 2 game points saved. Those were not the most optimistic claps in the corner from the Koreans. Sort of like, okay, let's see. Very guarded optimism. Oh. Seemed like it hit Timo in the hand. Tried to take it right off the bounce. Maybe some kick on that second bounce. Huh. I thought hand.
His thumb.
Thumb, there we go. Which technically, if we're going to get into biology here, part of the hand. Yes, one for me. And Timo takes it 11-4. 2-1 lead for Timo. Richard Krause, sports director of Germany, on his feet. And the Germans in position to tie things up. We will see game 4 coming up right after this. Back for game 4, Timo Boll in the lead, world 2, headband, forehand and all.
Fourth game, Germany to serve.
So the German flag right now behind in games, or in matches rather. Korea took the first, Lee Song-soo over Patrick Franziska. Timo, 1 game away from tying it up to give better chances to the German team. Spots 2, 3, and 4 for Germany are world 2 and 3. Nice bait. Gets Jung Young Shik over the forehand side of the table, then plays it deep the other way.
Good to see him playing that forehand from the backhand side. I think he's just got to show him, just threaten to be positive. Got to step round a few, play some forehands from the backhand side. Oh! Just what the doctor ordered. Forehand from the back.
Comes back to hit the net clamp. Now, in theory, if that comes up and comes down on the opponent's side of the table, it's still in play, but the ball comes back to where it came from. Now, in terms of if it hits camera, that's very, this is a good view here. Duck and cover. Wow, that was scary in the booth. People at home falling off of couches, out of computer chairs. Put on your 3D glasses, folks. Funny, in terms of the most analyzed points, in terms of what does or does not count, Timo versus Lin Gaoyuan had one of the most fascinating shots I've ever seen. The discussion went on for hours and hours before the truth was revealed by Discovery, and the call was right. Lin Gaoyuan's point. Do you remember that one, Don?
No, I don't.
Lin Gaoyuan hits a ball that hits the net, comes down on Timo's side of the table, comes back into the net, and comes down at what appears to be the clamp of the net, but actually hit something called the chassis, or the chassis if it's not French, that was just side of the table. Timo dives face down into the ground and hits a roller on the table. Oh, beautiful inside out here. But it turns out the point was over as soon as it hit that chassis. because that's a table, and it was just essentially second bounce. Still a lot of people discussing it, and in real time, it was just too tough to tell. Had to see it in slow motion, zoomed in high definition. Fortunate to have access to that footage. So Timo's got the crowd behind him in the lead, 4-2, leading 2-1. Jill DePille in the house. Jill Parker just came in and offered us some beverages. The healthiest one's water. Good block by Timo, right back to where it came from. Timo's probably the most drastic example of this I've ever seen, but knowing where the opponent is going to go, I've seen him lob down an Olympian in a small space. I had a chance to play him in Los Angeles in a match where I was trying 110%, and he was probably trying about 5. And he was always waiting wherever I thought I was going to fool him. Look at the power from the backhand, Don.
Super play from Bolt. He really has gone to town in game 3 and 4. He's still got a little bit of work to do, but if he keeps this going for another couple of minutes,
he'll be in recovery mode and ready for match number 4. And it's actually up to him to determine that. He has to win this match for there to be a 4th guaranteed. Other than that, he's leaving it up to Dima in the 3rd for a decent chance.
I'm not sure what his strategy is between the end of this game and the start of the 4th game. Maybe an ice bath somewhere he jumps in, or I'm not sure if that's what the German table tennis players do, but I'm sure, again, that's something they will have thought of.
You think they have an ice bath here?
I'm not sure if that's something they do.
Hmm.
Then I'm sure they do have, because they have temporary ones now, don't they? Mobile ones you can tuck around with you.
Note to self, next birthday, get portable ice bath.
I could have won you a couple of games just with that one piece of information, one piece of advice.
You heard it from Dr. Don.
Ice baths for your birthday.
Not the most typical, but you know what? Probably the best gift. Oh, beautiful shot. To go that far around the corner and still play it to the short side. I mean, he didn't have a lot of margin for error here. Good rotation on that, too. The serve looked like he almost contacted it reverse pendulum style, but the serve had the pendulum rotation, so quite crafty and clever. Awkward, slow, and spinny. Top and side from Timo. The variation of spins in his game from behind the table. Look how much arc there is. That one even more than the one before. He's stayed in a lot of points with some of those backhands from behind the table. Second towel break of game number 4. Timo drying his hand despite having just had a towel break. Still wiping the sweat from his palms up near the net on the table. I wonder if that's more of a rhythm thing, you know, just sort of part of the routine.
Again, he's just throwing that backhand up, hasn't he? Just giving it a little bit of extra air. Rather than going through the ball, he's brushing up the back. There it goes.
Yeah, that's a really high arcing ball. It's the second point in a row that I recall now of him winning with those high arcing spinny backhands. Coming up with his plan right now, the architect on the serve. A beautiful counter. I feel like when Timo served that, he says, the likelihood is I'm going to try to keep it on the table, but if he's going to go for the opening attack, which I hope he does and hope he can't contact it, that if he does, I'm ready with the backhand to rock and roll.
He certainly rock and rolled.
Indeed.
That was a heck of a backhand topspin.
Rock and bull. So now, 6 game and match points for the man with more blades named after him than anybody on the planet. Ooh, not so fast. Jung Young Chick saves one, but still a ways to go. So now 5 match points left. Takes it, Timo Boll. 3-1 over Jung Young Chick. So back from injury in good shape.